Joseph had a broken heart. And this guy was determined to fix it.
Over the course of my career, I've done over 1,000 open heart surgeries in children with congenital heart disease.
This was one of the most complicated cases he'd ever seen.
His body could only work so long with that kind of a heart.
Joseph's parents had a decision to make.
He might be able to have this really risky surgery, but yet a life-changing surgery for him.
To fix his heart, they needed a new approach. So they made an exact copy. A 3D printed heart. Lori and Ryan love kids.
It's a party here every day. We have 7 kids: Justin, Jackson, Jordan, James, Jessica, Joseph, and Jacob. 3 biological, 4 adopted, 3 have congenital heart disease.
Lori remembers when she first saw Joseph.
I fell in love with his face. We knew right away he had a severe congenital heart disease. He had already had 2 surgeries in China. At some point, his heart would peter out and he would need a new heart.
So they found out he was a candidate for a pretty risky type of heart surgery, something called a biventricle repair. If the surgery was successful, he wouldn't need a future heart transplant. He could keep his repaired heart forever.
Failing to prepare is preparing to fail. In our field, is even more critical.
So this is Dr. Anagnostopoulos, Dr. A for short.
Every patient is different. The margin for error is small due to the patient's size.
Dr. A said Joseph's heart was one of the most complicated he'd ever seen.
He had 5 different things that were abnormal.
1.
There were a couple of big holes inside his heart.
2.
There was a valve that was abnormally formed.
3.
The great arteries leaving the heart were flipped.
4.
The veins were coming to the wrong side in the upper chambers of the heart.
And 5.
His heart, rather than looking to the left side, it was looking to the right side.
Enter the 3D printer.
It has been thought as the ultimate visualization technique.
This is Alejandro. He's a researcher at the University of Wisconsin-Madison.
Visualization is a key factor for surgeons before they do surgery because they are gonna face something that they have only seen in 2 dimensions when they see an image.
Here we're looking at Joseph's heart. We start by acquiring high resolution images of the heart. We then generate a model using 3D printing.
So having a model like this that you can print cheaply allows surgeons to do all kinds of things.
You see here we cut out the front part of the heart in order to be able to see inside.
They can actually look inside. They can print the exact size or blow it up. They can hold it in their hands. And Dr. A did all of this before Joseph's surgery.
Believe me, I spend a lot of hours looking at the model and preparing for that surgery. You kind of feel like an athlete or musician who's about to perform. You get into the zone. So that's how I approach it. You get locked in, you get in the zone, and you try to get the job done.
They had kind of 3 stages that Dr. A had to do throughout the surgery. And we knew this going into the surgery. If each step went well, he would complete the 5-vent repair. You know, we kind of celebrated as each step went. We knew we were one closer to the full repair.
The surgery lasted over 10 hours.
Joseph's surgery was a success. They did the 3D heart to prepare for it, and that was just incredible. And he's a healthy little boy now. It's pretty incredible that he went from a kid who needed the possibility of a new heart one day to a kid who will have this heart forever.
For a complicated surgery like Joseph's, having this model made a big difference. The team is trying to take this technology further they're starting to 3D print the hearts of unborn babies to be ready for surgery right when they're born. And they're connecting tubes to these 3D printed hearts to better understand how different surgery tactics will affect blood flow. Ultimately, it comes down to creating a more customized approach to medicine.
The big advantage in my mind right now is that you can personalize the models and be able to prepare the teams.
And in the future, Dr. A thinks that 3D models could have a huge impact on the way that surgeons train.
And as we change the materials that we use, we're going to be able to take the hearts of unusual patients, print them, and potentially do the operation 4 or 5 times before we even get into the operating room.
And as for Joseph?
He's a healthy little boy now. He's just as active as any other little kid. You wouldn't know it at all that he has a heart condition. He can essentially live a normal life. We're just happy to be part of finding a solution that is going to help kids now and in the future. We can't wait to see what happens next.